Good morning, everyone. Yesterday we were studying about the transportation in plants. Our today's topic is transportation in human. So what is the need of the transportation in the human being? As I told you yesterday, to transport the oxygen to each and every cell of the body, to transport the CO2 back to the lungs, to transport the food, and to transport the nitrogenous waste to the kidneys, right? Yesterday we have done the transportation in plants, but today's our topic is transportation in human beings. Now the question arises, what are the components of the transportation in human, right? So the components of the transportation in human is blood and lymph, the transporting medium by which each and every information transport from one part to the another in the body. Second one is blood vessels, the place or the tubes in which the transporting medium will flow, right? And the main important thing is, or the main important organ is heart, the pumping organ by which the blood pumps throughout our body. Today we are discussing the structure of the heart externally or internally. You all know, or I told you before so many times, that heart is completely situated in between our two lungs. It is broad at the upper side but narrow at the lower side. Its lower side is slightly tilted towards the right side. Okay, therefore our left lung is slightly smaller than the right lung, right? Next thing is, the size of the heart is just like our fist. Jitni badi hamari mutthi hai, utna hi bada hamara heart ka size hoga. Theek hai? Heart is completely enveloped with the pericardium. You can see the structure here, that it is double membranous structure and the membranes are said to be pericardium. The envelope completely known as pericardium. You can see here, in between the membranes, the pericardial fluid is present. Why the pericardial fluid is present here in between the membrane or in the envelope? To prevent the friction or to prevent the heart from the outer injury. You cannot see any sort of partition at the upper side, but when we see the internal structure of heart is completely divided into four chambers. Two uppermost chambers here you can see, and two lowermost chambers, right? You can see this is the left part of the human heart and this is the right one. This is left auricle, this is right auricle. The uppermost chambers are known as auricles and the lowermost are known as ventricle, left ventricle and right ventricle. Clear? The left part of the human heart is completely separated from the right one by means of this septum. This is septum or wall which divide the human heart into two equal heart. This septum, you can see here very clearly, right? You can see here the whole heart is covered with the double membranous structure. Whole heart. This is the double membranous structure, pericardium. Right? The left part of the human heart is completely separated from the right one. You can see here very clearly. Uppermost chambers are auricles and lowermost are the ventricles. Auricles, or you can say atrium also. Both the things are same. and lower most are ventricles. Auricles are the receiving chambers and ventricles are the transporting chambers. Means auricles receives the blood, whether the blood is oxygenated or deoxygenated, and ventricles transport the blood, whether the blood is oxygenated or deoxygenated. So what is the oxygenated blood? Oxygen rich blood. Deoxygenated blood, carbon dioxide rich blood. So from where the oxygenated blood comes, from where the deoxygenated blood comes, naturally you can say the oxygenated blood comes from the lungs, right? Because the absorption of O2 takes place inside the lungs in the alveolar area, correct? So auricles are the receiving chambers and ventricles are the transporting chambers. Two auricles are completely separated from each other by the interauricular septum, or you can divide the septum into two parts. Whenever it divides the auricles, the two auricles, it is said to be interauricular septum. When it divides the ventricles, you can say interventricular septum. So the left part is completely separated from the right one by means of the septum or the wall, you can say. But this is the left auricle, or you can say the left auricle can opens into the left ventricle and right auricle opens into the right ventricle. Because the left auricle contains the oxygenated blood, although the left one is also contain, left ventricle also contains the oxygenated blood, the right auricle and the right ventricle contains the deoxygenated blood. The left auricle receives the oxygenated blood by means of two pair, here you can write two pairs of pulmonary veins. Veins, artery are the blood vessels. I will explain you later on. So, left auricle receives the oxygenated blood by means of two pairs of pulmonary veins. So, from where the oxygenated blood receives? From the lungs. So, left auricle receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs. Right? So, this is one of the veins. Second thing is, left auricle receives the deoxygenated blood. From where the deoxygenated blood comes? From the whole part of body, whether it is arms, upper arms, head or the lower part of the body, right? So right auricle receives the deoxygenated blood from the upper part of the body and the lower part of the body. From the hand or from the upper part of the body, it receives the deoxygenated blood by means of superior vena cava. This one, you can see here very clearly, this is the superior vena cava and this is inferior vena cava. The heart receives the deoxygenated blood from the body by means of superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. These are also the veins. The receiving work of the blood or the veins are the receiving vessels. Here you can see clearly. Second thing is, left ventricle transport the blood throughout the body and right ventricle transport the blood to the lungs back to diffuse out the carbon dioxide from the lungs. Okay. So, left ventricle transport the oxygenated blood throughout the body by means of the single huge thick wall large blood vessel, that is aorta. A single blood vessel is sufficient to transport the oxygenated blood from left ventricle to the whole body, whether it is uppermost part or the lower part of the body. Here you can see very clearly, this is the aorta. Actually, this is not the 3D structure of the human heart. So you can see only one side of the human heart. You can see here very clearly. This is left ventricle, and the blood goes from there. And this is from here the aorta will start and transport the blood throughout the body. Clear? And right ventricle transport the blood to the lungs back. From where? Here, this is the pulmonary artery. This is pulmonary artery, and by means of pulmonary artery, the blood, deoxygenated blood, goes back to the lungs for the further oxygenation. So you can say the heart receives the oxygenated or deoxygenated blood by means of blood vessels, that is veins, but transport the blood throughout the body or to the lungs back by means of arteries. Clear to all? As I told you, left auricle opens inside the left ventricle. So here should be a partition to flow the blood from here to here. How? You can see here very clearly there is some opening or the connecting point in between the left auricle and left ventricle. This connection or this opening or this way is known as the valve. And on the left side of the human heart, which valve is present? Bicuspid valve. I am writing here bicuspid valve. You can mention there also bicuspid valve. Another valve is present here also in between the right auricle and right ventricle. This is tricuspid valve. So in between the auricle and ventricle, the valves are present. On the left side, the bicuspid valve. On the right side, the tricuspid valve. And on the ventricles, whether it is left or right, semilunar valves are present. Semilunar valves. The shape of the valve is like the lunar form of the moon. Therefore, it is known as semilunar valve. So, three valves are present on the opening of left ventricle. Where is the opening of left ventricle? Here. And three valves are present on the opening of right ventricle. Where is the opening of right ventricle? Here. You can see here only the right ventricle in front. On the back side, the left ventricle opening is there. Right? So, this is the whole structure of the human heart. I am repeating again. The human heart is completely separated into four chambers. The uppermost chambers are auricles and the lowermost are ventricles. Auricles are the receiving chambers. Therefore, the walls of auricle is very thin comparatively to the ventricles. The lowermost chambers are ventricles. These are also known as transporting chambers. The left auricle receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs by means of two pairs of pulmonary veins. And right auricle receives the deoxygenated blood by means of superior and inferior vena cava. The right auricle receives the blood from the body by means of superior and inferior vena cava. Right? There are two blood vessels. Left ventricle transport the blood throughout the body. Which blood? Oxygenated. By means of single artery, the thick artery, that is aorta. Further, it will divide it into so many small arterioles. And right ventricle transport the deoxygenated blood to the lungs back by means of pulmonary artery. So left part of the human heart contains the oxygenated blood, oxygen rich blood. And right part contains the deoxygenated blood, carbon dioxide rich blood, right? We can fill the red color to show the oxygenated blood here, and we can fill the blue color to show the deoxygenated blood on the right side of the human heart. So this is all about the human heart. You can practice the diagram from the NCERT. You can draw this diagram also, or you can draw diagram from NCERT also, and you can practice the diagram 3 or 4 times. This is very tough. Next, we will take the working of heart, how the heart pumps or how the heart transport the blood throughout the body, right?